Just a reminder for the senior girls basketball team to return all your jerseys to the gym office by today after school. The Fashion for a Cause meeting is canceled for today. All club heads, please report to room 129 right at the beginning of lunch.
Rumors throughout my school.
And I talked about it with my parents. Maybe the teachers.
Probably one of my classes.
What Bill Maxwell-Steele meant to me when we first heard about it was, maybe this sounds kind of selfish, but it meant my year would be ruined.
To be honest, I still don't really know what Bill 115 is, but it had something to do with not allowing your extracurriculars to go on.
I never really heard about Bill 115 until November, December, when it became a reality at our school.
So everyone in the school is just like, oh yeah, 115, you never really thought it was going to happen to York Mills.
Well, at first I was confused because I didn't understand what it was. I thought it was the teachers just refusing to do things. And once I actually heard about it, I thought what was happening to the teachers was kind of wrong in a sense.
I didn't really think it was going to be a big deal. I knew that we were losing sports, but I thought it was not going to be for that long.
I was uncertain as to how long it would last.
I didn't think it would last the whole year.
I thought the conflict would last a lot longer than it did, maybe because I was kind of pessimistic.
So there wasn't very much communicated to us, it was just an idea.
I think there was a big gap between the students and what was going on. Like, they didn't communicate that much to the teachers, I guess.
We still didn't know what that meant for us, and I just felt like we were always trying to figure things out, but we never really knew.
You had to kind of watch the news to find out what was going on.
It's definitely our school spirit, because essentially every club at York Mills, they provide something.
I would say that the biggest loss was definitely intramurals, because it was a place for us to all kind of congregate.
I just know that every time that we used to go to the gym for the intramurals, it was like kind of a sense of community, and we kind of lost that.
So every single lunch, we kind of had like our own thing in the gym, like intramurals, like it was a lot of fun, and that was a big part of like the student life.
I think it put a little bit of a strain on the student-teacher relationship.
The atmosphere of the school got a lot less enthusiastic and a lot less spirited.
You had other students in the school who kind of just saw what the media portrayed as the teachers being kind of selfish in some senses.
And after, once everyone came to the realization that it wasn't them, we kind of were behind them and like supporting them.
I don't necessarily think the relationship changed that much. Maybe some students were a bit bitter.
It brought them a bit closer because we were kind of fighting for them.
Sports are what makes York Mills York Mills.
York Mills is one of the athletic schools that we have. Like, some schools are more like academic, some schools are more artistic. We're like an athletic school, so without like intramurals during lunch or whatever, students were like pretty much lost.
I chose to participate in the protest because I felt that it was our, we needed to show our support for the teachers and how much extracurriculars actually do mean to us.
Well, I organized the York Mills walkout, and once that started, everyone was more serious into it, and that was the main purpose of the York Mills walkout, was to educate so they would be more into it and be ready for the Queen's Park protest.
Because I wanted my clubs back.
And it was a peaceful protest. There were 2 to 3 call cars that came, and when I spoke to them, they told me that it was the most peaceful walkout that they visited. And it was very organized. Even my principals, vice principal and the principal said that it went really well.
It got me very riled up, and I just wanted to do something about it because it was so ridiculous to everyone that it had to have been able to be stopped. There had to have been a way to go over, like, to skip over the whole actually taking away our extracurriculars and just solving it like mature adults.
The whole movement was together. It was unifying all the clubs that we lost, all the sports that we lost, and just showing our protest together. And it unified the entire GTA, because at Queen's Park there were like 5,000 people, like, that came out eventually.
I really don't think that a lot of the people that didn't participate, it's not that they didn't want to, it's just that they were just uninformed, and like, I was kind of like that. I didn't really know what was happening, so like, I guess I couldn't really help that.
I just wish that there was another way, that possibly they could have found another way.
They made a statue of us and put it on a mountaintop. Now tourists come and stare at us.
Meeting about Bill 150, and I remember there was a lot of commotion, which clubs are going to stay, which ones are more important than others, which is a really like unfair thing to like to tell someone.
I guess the club heads meeting just kind of turned into not like something like, hey, what can we do in the future, but it turned into something like, what can we do about something like, we can't even plan about the future anymore because we're struggling about what we're going to do tomorrow. Like, are we even going to be there tomorrow? Like, are we going to be able to survive one more day as a club?
I was in denial and doubting everything absolutely because we love our teachers and we know at York Mills we're very lucky with the teachers we have.
Every time we heard that there was a meeting was, are we going to find out that it's over? Is there just going to be one more week? Are we going back to normal?
It was really hard to hear that we couldn't and that there were restrictions on which clubs can continue next year.
It was not a good time.
I mean, the admin can only work with what they have and there's only three of them. So they have some limitations there as well. And they did what they needed to do. I mean, there's some clubs that are just fundamentally more important to the school than others.
Obviously for me, because I was mainly involved with student council, I was happy that they kept student council going. But I did feel bad because I'm part of some of the smaller clubs, and I know that they weren't able to continue on with staff supervision, which is obviously hard, especially if you're in grade 12 and you really want to stay involved this year.
Some people are really passionate about some of the clubs that they're in, like art clubs or music clubs or even like sports. And I don't think that it's fair that they chose to keep some clubs because it's like saying that they're what they believe, what they're passionate about doesn't matter and that it's not important.
some of the clubs and activities are pretty important for the school, so other clubs can fall back a bit.
I think it was nice to get closer with admin because usually we're working with teachers, but at the same time I felt it was difficult because they had never done this stuff before.
A little bit of background and told them what it was about and told them that we couldn't run everything, the club heads together started to prioritize. And so the club heads were also told that the staff advisors would be me and the two vice principals. So there were three of us, and so they understood that we could only do so much. And through that prioritization, we came up with the clubs that went ahead and the events that went ahead, and everyone pitched in where they could. So it worked out really, really well. It was, I think, one of the best collaborative activities that that we had, that I experienced, certainly with club heads and the extracurricular members. That was the hardest thing, to see that disappointment. And for me and for many teachers, that really got to them. That really, really got to them. The best part, and I have to say it was quite spectacular, is that that I got to work with some students, and certainly the grade 12 students, who I always get to know just when they're about to leave. We got to know our students quite well. I got to know the grade 10s well, a lot of the grade 10s who showed a whole lot of leadership skills, my goodness. And I think the best part was that the grade 11 students and 12 students, especially the club heads, really displayed those leadership qualities and became role models for the grade 10s. And I think that's very important because we want to maintain that same momentum. We want to maintain that same tradition of quality and integrity for our clubs. So I think that was the best part. The best part was being involved, feeling the joy, you know, getting the excitement of going for whatever event we had. And then, of course, you know, the downer after it's over and you think, okay, what do we do next? There was always something to do next. Well, I'll tell you, I was getting home late one night and I bumped into a neighbor. And the neighbor said, oh, you're just getting home now. And it was one of the rehearsals for the show, or I can't even remember what it was for. And I said, oh yes, it's very busy at school. And she said, how do you stand those teenagers? I thought, oh my gosh, I felt like the mother hen, or maybe the mother wolf, who was going to tear this lady's face apart. And I said, what do you mean, these teenagers? And she says, oh, they're all troubled. And I said, you don't have a clue. You don't have a clue. When I tell you the teenagers today are far more mature and far more knowledgeable than you ever were when you were a teenager, or I ever was when I was a teenager.
I guess it was just confusing for like heads as clubs of clubs, and then you didn't know what to say to like the members of the clubs.
Tech crew only lives because of the events that other clubs host, right? It's not that we just maintain ourselves. What we do is all based on the things that other clubs do, and because I found out that a lot of the clubs that we work for are being scrapped, and that kind of puts us out of a bad position too, because now we have nothing to do.
You can't just keep asking the admin every day to come in and help us, because they do have a job to run and they are in a difficult situation as well.
Making events became like 10 times harder in every aspect. I mean, collecting money from students was 10 times harder because we needed an admin to be there when we operated the cash box. Planning the events became harder. Knowing how many people would attend our events became harder. Supervision for the actual event became harder to find. So, I mean, if everything got 10 times harder, it was extremely difficult to run small events.
Having clubs deprived from us for so long, everybody was really excited. It was kind of like whatever was given to us, we took advantage of more than we would have if they had been present throughout the entire year.
You know, when you take away the bigger events, the smaller ones become all the more important. So yeah, I mean, like, for Valentine's Day or Project Kindness even, those were certain things that students cherished more.
And so one of the bigger things was Project Kindness, and we had a whole week of events, and that kind of helped forget the fact that it took us so long to get clubs running again.
All the media attention that we got, and the fact that the superintendents of the TDSB want to implement this in all the schools now, I think that was really rewarding.
Major events didn't really take over.
I definitely think I have grown as a leader just because a lot of the year I had to be more independent than I would have been if we did have staff advisors.
Well, for me personally, I had to because I had to be the head of prom committee because the teacher who was supposed to be the head couldn't.
Absolutely, because I kind of, along with Farrell and Philip for YMAC, we had to take on the role of the teachers as well as the president and vice president.
I mean, you do the best with what you have, and you work with it.
You realize how important clubs and sports are to you when you don't have them, so when they come back, you're more excited for them.
We met in the halls on our own time without supervision because we wanted to continue our project that we already started at the beginning of the year.
I think it kind of put the ones that were really dedicated and brought them closer together because, well, they had to fight to keep their club alive, and if they didn't have a classroom, they still met in the halls.
I don't think it was a loss here. I don't think so at all because in the end, we did get 2 out of our 3 sports seasons, which is really important too.
I wouldn't say that the year is lost just because, I mean, sure, you're going to look back on it with a bitter taste in your mouth, but at the end of the day, like, it is what it is and life goes on.
Understanding of what was going to happen, so we all had high hopes and then we were all let down again and so on and so forth.
They did also, like I said, not want to scare anyone and any of the students because extracurriculars do mean a lot to us, and having them taken away from us at any point would just be scary. And it goes to light, a la 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 light, a la 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 light, a la la
la light, a la 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 light, a la 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 light. I don't think it was too late to change the school's atmosphere, especially if we were in grade 12, because everybody was just so eager to have something happen.
By the time they were resumed, I mean, people are getting into their culminatings and exam schedules. They're so used to scheduling their time without extracurriculars that the whole shift for a month of school was too complicated.
I think our specific school has a lot of enthusiasm, so even throughout the whole Bill 115, we still semi-kept up our enthusiasm.
I think at first, when Bill 115 was first being talked about and all the rumors were going around, the community was closer than ever because everyone had the, you know, common goal of fixing it and having their extracurriculars and finding out what they could do about it.
A bit of both, because some students kind of were like, oh, the school year's ruined, and kind of just were Debbie Downers. But then there were some other students which kind of found other ways to be involved.
I think it kind of made the student body come together because we all want the same thing. We want our extracurriculars back.
I think students did come together in some aspects, as in like how they protested with the walkout and everything, and I think that helped a lot.
I think it really brought students together because usually I feel like clubs divide students, especially between major clubs like Student Council, Environmental Council, and YMAC. But I felt as if since we were all going through this and we all had to have meetings in conference rooms or in hallways, we sympathized for one another. We tried working out ways where we didn't have events like running in with one another. So I think we kind of all felt we're on the same page. So I think we really came together.
Thank you.
extracurriculars are a huge part of not just any school, but especially York Mills.
When you really want something, you're going to have to step up and try to make the change yourself.
I hope that they learn that as even though sometimes situations become difficult, we have a group of kids. If you want to do something, you can do it.
I think in a way it's really inspiring for the grade 10s and 11s, and that they definitely should not take extracurriculars for granted. For a lot of grade 12s, this is our last year, and we really wanted to be involved as much as we can, and we couldn't given the circumstances.
I will look back on this year as it being bittersweet.
I don't know, I still look at it as a year spent with my friends, just like any other year.
I'm glad to see that we all kind of came together as a family, especially shown through the student protests, that we all wanted to keep extracurriculars, and that was inspiring to me.
I'll think that it was a really great year, and actually when I think about this year, I don't think about the protests at all. It's not the first thing that comes to my mind.
You know, we're out there all standing towards something that we're all faced with. And, I mean, we got our voices heard and we stood together as one. So, yeah, definitely showed some type of pride there.
For the events that the clubs did hold, that, hey, you know what? We can do it. We can actually do it. We can be amazing, you know, thoughtful, considerate citizens of the world. And, I mean, that's just a whole lot of pride. Truth. The world is in good hands. This world is in good hands.